what you heard. It's what you hearing. It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. X gon' give it to you. What? Wait for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to you. Knock, knock. Open up the door. It's real. With the non-stop pop out from stainless steel. Go hard getting busy with it. But I got such a good heart that I make a mother wonder if you get it. Damn right, and I do it again. Cause yeah. I am life, so I got to win.
Welcome back to Any Heroics with at least the fourth best member of Any Heroics. It's me, Elliot, and today, as you saw by the little montage, Mardin, this little eyepatch chappy here, is going to go to his first ever GBHL 100 tournament. Definitely for me, maybe ever, because I'm really not sure who else would be insane enough to take this guy. But what we're going to do is we're going to see how he performs over the weekend, we're going to see if he's underappreciated, and we're going to see if we can actually get any use out of this really cool model, but really, really not so cool profile. So let's get into some stats. I'll put them up on the screen so you can see. But for anyone who's blind, I don't know why I'm saying this. So let's start with some stats. So for anyone who has two eye patches over their eyes and can't see what's on the screen, Mardin is fight 5 with a shoot value 4+, which is pretty much useless. Move 5, like every other dwarf in the game. Strength 4, pretty average. D7, which sounds nice on paper, but then actually when you compare him to just a regular dwarf warrior, who's also D7, kind of a little bit shit. 2 attacks, which is standard captain behaviour, except he's got a big spear, so he wants to be spear supporting, so you never get 2 attacks, so meh. 2 wounds, meh. Courage 5, which is kind of nice, but he also has Sworn Protector, Durin, I can't talk, Sworn Protector Durin, and because Durin's also fearless, that means that he basically constantly has immunity, which is kind of nice, as long as Durin's alive. He has 3 might, which is his only selling point in this entire profile, because that's very hard to come by in Khazad-dum, like 2 might is very, very prevalent. He has 1 will, 1 fate, so standard kind of named captain behaviour. And he's got Torazul, which is a foe spear with the Trollbane special rule, which means that he causes D3 wounds instead of 1 wound to trolls, which is kind of cool. And then additionally, he also gets +1 when rolling to wound against monster models, which means if he's supporting an Iron Shield as part of the Vault Warden teams, he'll actually get +2 to wound against monsters, which, if I happen to come up against a troll this weekend, which I very, very highly doubt, he would get +2 to wound D3 wounds, which is kind of cool. Heroic actions, he's literally got heroic strength, and that is it, which is, I think, as heroes go, that is probably the worst heroic action set available to man or dwarf. And that's pretty much it. But he does have a very, very cool eye patch, and that's what we're relying on to carry us through. So yeah, so that's his base stats. We're going to take him to the tournament. We're going to see how he does. Might chuck in some little clips here and there of the games and what else is going on. And then we'll come back at the end of the weekend and I'll give you my proper thoughts about how he performs as a model, and is he the most underappreciated model in MESBG? X gon' give it to you. Wait for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to you. Knock, knock, open up the door, it's real. With the right, so we are back after the 2-day tournament in Sheffield using Mardin, and I'm sure the 3 people who are interested really want to know how he got on, how he performed. So let me do a bit more of a Mardin review now, and then we'll kind of get into the good stuff. So bad. Mardin is bad. I really tried to make him work and he is just not good. And I'm not, he's packed away in the case, so he can't hear me say it. But besides the eye patch, the benefits really start running kind of like slim. Good points, 3 points to my, I'd like to say was good. But to be quite honest, because he's always, near enough always, not in your front line and he's in the second rank, he was never really in a spot to be calling heroic moves. I did it like once or twice when I could, but he was never really in a spot because obviously then if the line moves forward, even the Iron Shield he was supporting has kind of gone without him and now gets a penalty. He's just kind of like vibing at the back.
you also really couldn't use his might because he's only got one attack when he's spear supporting. You couldn't really use his might when, like, because you roll something like a 3 and you're just kind of like, do I want to spend 2 might or 3 might just to win a fight when he's probably not going to kill something? And you're like, probably not. So yeah, the first day he was absolutely fucking shocking. I'll pop in a clip now when I was fighting against a Gulliver.
So we've got Mardin on Gulliver. Would you like to roll a dice? There's a 6 there. Nice. Go for it. Poor Mardin.
You didn't throw that,
did
you?
No, I did not. 7. 4s. Oh, Mardin.
And yeah, that pretty much went as well as could be expected. I tried to bubble wrap him for pretty much the entire game, and he still got eaten. But in the other games, we also fought against a Forlog Mephat, against Imriel, against the lovely Harry Park Hill. And if you'd like to hear a more detailed description of what went down in that game, then be sure to check out the Entmoot podcast that Harry is doing for that episode, because I will feature on that. And then you can hear a real sort of more detailed analysis of that game and how I tried to use Mardin and what kind of went well and didn't go well. So he kind of got eaten by Forlong in that game. And then I think he ended up dying in my third game as well with 2 might in the store, which is never a good thing. And again, I think it comes down to that. Never really a good chance to use his might, unfortunately, which is kind of the crux of his whole profile, I think. And in terms of pure competitive sense, if you want to take a 75-point hero in Khazad-dum, please just take a Dwarf King or take a Dwarf Captain with a shield. Well, like, whatever you want to take, just don't take him. Having the fight 6 on a Dwarf King, having an extra point of will, having March, having Resolve, having Defense 8, it's all just so much better. But yeah, so that's kind of the gist. Day 2, he started a little bit better, as I started to do a little bit better in the tournament. But yeah, his uses are very, very few and far between. However, there was one very, very cool moment in my second game on the second day. Look to the east. where I was lucky enough to play against someone called Adam Kent, who had these lovely troll conversions that were all basically like pirates. So it was birder and a load of trolls. Which, yeah, basically meant it was... And... boy, did he show his quality. So, for all intents and purposes, I guess, you know, he's kind of built for one thing. And yeah, I guess I'll pop the clip in now and you guys can see how it goes. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this little sort of side video all wrapped around Mardin. If there's a particularly not good hero or character or something that you really want me to go and try and just have a miserable time with, then feel free to comment it down below. I'm more than happy to try and take anything fluffy and really try and make it work and have some fun with it. So we'll see how that game went against Birda. And yeah, if you'd like to pick up your very own Mardin, then you can do so at Firestorm Games using the link down below. I don't know if I'd recommend buying it for Mardin, but you do get Durin, who is actually good. But yeah, so I hope you enjoyed and let's roll to the clip.
Durin and Mardin in on Birda. Durin's done his strike. Birda's on a 4 high.
Instead of a 1 and 2 fours, we're on a 1 and
right.
2
right, so we're just going to do Mardin's strike. Nope. And then we'll do Durin's dice. Oh, you rolled a 4.
Yeah,
so
rolled.
That's enough.
Goodbye, sweet prince.
Here we go then. So Mardin with the spear against the troll. So he gets plus 2 to wound. And it's D3 wounds. So your defense 6.
Defense 6.
Strength 4. So it would be 5s, down to 4s, down to 3s. Come on, Mardin, this is your one time to shine. Oh, I'll spend a mic point. I'll spend a mic point. Cool, so you can prevent it with fate.
One fate.
And if you don't prevent it with fate,
it fails it.
So it'll be D3 wounds. So if I roll big here, Mardin's done it. Mardin's Mardin! Let's go! Give it to you.